Hello everyone. Today we are going to start the new chapter, Direct and Inverse Variation. This is the first introductory video on the chapter named Direct and Inverse Variation. Dear students, in your previous class, you have learned the concept of ratio, proportion, and also studied about unitary method. So today we are going to explore the chapter Direct and Inverse Variation, and in this chapter we would be understanding when do we say the two quantities they are in variation. So we will be understanding the concept of variation, then we will be exploring situations of two different type of variations. One we name as direct variation and the second we name as inverse variation. After that, we will be solving certain questions which are based on this concept, and we will try to see in which daily life situations we apply this concept. So let us begin this. Now imagine a situation that in a family there are four members and each member consumes 5 milliliters of milk every day. So it is good to drink milk. So if we try to see in this situation, we can easily find out daily consumption of the milk by the family. Here in a family there are four members and it is given that each member consumes 500 milliliter of milk every day. So what is the daily consumption? The daily consumption of the family will be 2 liters. Okay, now if there is a family in which there are 6 family members, so you see that here 2 more members are there in the family, and again the situation is that each member consumes 500 milliliter of milk every day. So what will be the daily consumption of the milk by the whole family when there are 6 family members? Of course it will increase, and it will be, in this situation it will be 3 liters. Right. Now you again imagine if there are 8 family members, then in that case what will happen? The daily consumption of the milk by the family will be 4 liters. So now you see, if there are 4 members, the consumption of milk in the family is 2 liters. If there are 6 members, it is 3 liters. If there are 8 members, there are 4 liters. So what do you observe in this situation? So we notice that as we increase the number of family members, the consumption of milk by the family every day will also increase. So let us represent this in the form of a table. So it will appear like this. So we can represent the information in the tabular form. So now you tell me, if there are 10 members in the family, then what will be the consumption of milk in liters? Yes, it will be 5 liters. Okay, now you have to tell me about these statements, and you just tell me, do you agree with these statements? First statement says, the more time I drive at a constant rate, the more distance I cover. What do you think about this statement? The first statement. Yes, it is true. What about the second one? If you increase a recipe for more people, the more of ingredients you need. You can imagine it like if you have to make 1 cup of tea. Now you tell me, in 1 cup of tea, there is a fixed quantity which you use for making 1 cup of tea. some amount of water, some amount of milk, then some tea leaves and some amount of sugar. There is a fixed quantity. Now, if you have to make a cup of tea for two number of people, that means you have to prepare two cups of tea. So what will happen? You will be requiring more number of ingredients. It is again depending on the number of people for which you need to prepare the food. Okay, now coming to the third one. So in a computer shop, if you go and you play online games, you basically, here it is given, if you play more hours of online games, you need to pay more money. But remember one thing, you should not play much of online games. This is not so good for health, not good for eyes, not good for brain. So you need to control this, that when you are playing an online game, it should be very, very minimum the time you have spent. You just see, like, you should not spend more time on playing online games. Okay, coming on to next. Let us now see what happens when we imagine this situation now. I'm coming on to this one. Here also, you see, it is representing the same thing. So, ingredients are listed, quantities are mentioned for preparing coffee or for preparing tea basically. And if it is one cup of tea, then how much water is required, then quantity of sugar, then quantity of tea leaves and quantity of milk. So as you increase the number of cups of the tea, then you need to increase the quantity of the ingredients, right? Okay, moving on further. Okay, let us discuss this one. Say for example, we are given that one toffee costs rupee 2. The cost of one toffee is rupees 2. Now you tell me, what will be the cost of two toffees? Will it increase or decrease? Yes, it will increase and it will be rupees 4. Okay, now tell me, what will be the cost of 3 toffees? I'm just making replicas of this. Now you tell me, if there are 3 toffees, what will be the cost? The cost will be rupees 6. So what do you observe in this situation? Here also you see, as you increase the number of toffees, the cost is also increased, right? Okay. So now observe this particular situation. This is very interesting. Suppose you have to complete a particular work and 16 workers, they require 30 days, but 20 workers, they require 24 days. So what is here in this situation? Of course, in this situation, an increase in the number of workers decreases the number of days which is required for completing that particular work. So as you increase the number of helpers to do certain work, the work will be finished in lesser time. Okay. So here also you see, there is a concept of variation involved. So basically, when do we say that two quantities are in variation? So in the previous slide, I used the term variation, because change in one quantity is giving rise to change in the other quantity correspondingly. So we say that if the values of two quantities, they are related in such a way that change in the one results in corresponding change in the other. This is very, very important. Change in the one results in corresponding change in the other. Then we say the two quantities are in variation. So now there are two different situations. So first we are going to understand the concept of direct variation. So when do we say that two quantities are in direct variation? So two quantities x and y are said to be in direct variation if x and y increase or decrease in such a way that x upon y remains constant. It's a positive number. So x upon y is constant, and here k is the constant of variation. So let us try to understand this by an example. So here, what do we mean by that? Let me take an example first. Say for example, here we are now understanding the example for direct variation. We have already seen many situations. Say for example, here let me add a table. Here we are taking two quantities x and y, and we see that let the value of x is 1 and value of y is 2. Value of x is 2 and here it is 4, y is 4. When it is 3, y is 6. Just try to analyze this first. I hope you can see this now better. Can you tell me what is the ratio x upon y in the first situation? It is 1 upon 2. Let me add one more row so that we can find out the ratio. Okay, so let us see what is x upon y. 1 upon 2. What is 2 upon 4? It is also 1 upon 2. What is 3 upon 6? It is also 1 upon 2. So here it is depicting the case of direct variation. Why? Because you see that here x and y are two quantities, and we are getting x upon y as constant, that is k. And what is k here? K has come out to be 1 by 2. Is it clear? Okay, now we will be using this concept for explaining this particular example. Find P and Q if x and y vary directly. Here we have to find the value of P and Q. It is given that x and y vary directly. So when you read this statement, x and y vary directly, it means x upon y is equal to k, that is constant, right? So in every situation, in every pair of values, that x upon y will be same. So that means if we are given in this table, 5 upon 8 should be equal to p upon 32, 5 upon 8 should be equal to 10 upon q. Okay, and we will be using this for solving the particular question. So we will write the statement, since x and y, they vary directly, so x upon y is equal to k, where k is constant of variation. And using this, we will first frame first equation, that 5 upon 8 is equal to p upon 32. Solve this, cross multiply, and you get p as 20. Similarly, 5 upon 8 is equal to 10 upon q, cross multiply, and you get q is equal to 16. I hope this is clear to you. I am repeating. When x and y are two quantities, then they are said to be in direct variations. If x and y increase or decrease in such a way that x upon y remains constant. So we say x upon y is equal to k, where k is constant of variation. I hope it is clear to you. Okay, let us now see example number 2. Verify whether x and y vary directly with each other. If so, find k. So in this question, what we are going to find out? We will be finding the ratio, that is x upon y. So let us see what is x upon y in the first case. 2 upon 6, that gives us 1 upon 3. 3 upon 9, this also gives us 1 upon 3. But here you notice that 5 upon 17, we cannot cancel. And 6 upon 20, we can simplify this. 2 3s are 6, and then 3 upon 10, we get 3 upon 10. So do you find that x upon y in all these cases is same? No, it is not same. So here, interestingly, you have to note one thing. You see, you must be noticing that x is increasing and y is also increasing, but there is no corresponding change basically as per the factor, which is x upon y, that is not constant. So correspondingly it is not changing, but yes, of course, as the value of x is increasing, y is increasing. Be careful and remember that if two quantities x and y increase or decrease together, it does not ensure that it is a case of direct variation. You need to check the ratio x upon y. And here x upon y should be same in all the situations. So 2 by 6, 3 by 9 is 3 by 9 is not same as 5 by 17. So we will observe this and say, okay, this is not the case of direct variation, right? Okay, moving on further, let us do another example. Here the question is, cost of 6 mineral water bottles. Cost of 6 mineral water bottles is rupees 90. How many mineral water bottles can be bought? How many mineral water bottles can be bought for rupees 225. You see, whenever I read the word water, na, it gives me that remembrance of this conserving water, save water. You know, water is very, very precious. We have to use it wisely. So whenever I read or speak the word water, this is the first thing which comes to my mind. Okay, so let us come back to the question. So cost of 6 mineral water bottles is rupees 90. So that means we are here given the number of water bottles, and the second quantity is the cost. So let us insert a table here first. So we will be making a table. So in the table, here we are going to write down number of mineral water bottles, and second thing is cost, and cost is given in rupees. Okay, so what is the number of mineral water bottles? First it is given 6, and the cost is given 90, and we have to find number of water bottles. So let that be x, and cost is given for rupees 225. Just make this table in your notebook also. Okay, now it is the case of direct variation, right? Now you tell me what happens in the case of direct variation. First we are going to write here, it is the case of direct variation. So as we increase the number of mineral water bottles, the cost will increase. So let us write it down. It is the case of direct variation. So 6 upon 90 should be equal to x upon 225. Why is it so? You know that when two quantities vary directly, so x upon y should be constant. Now you can simplify this. When you simplify this, you get x as 15. So write it down that 15 bottles, 15 mineral water bottles can be purchased, with rupees, for rupees 225. Is it clear? So this is the first thing which I wanted to share with you. So today we have understood what is the case of direct variation, and first we have understood what is variation, when do we say that two quantities are in variation, and then we have learned how to do questions which are based on direct variation, and we have understood the concept of direct variation, right? So now in the next class I would be discussing the worksheet which is given in the book. So be ready for that, and till then revise whatever we have done so far.